A Muzaffarnagar local court granted bail to BSP MP Kadir Rana, indicted of giving inflammatory speeches before Muzaffarnagar communal riots broke out in August. Chief Judicial Magistrate KP Singh has allowed Rana's bail on payment of two sureties of 20,000 rupees each. The bail was given on the ground of Rana fainting in jail and has been hospitalized. The Andhra Pradesh Assembly was adjourned till Thursday as the Telangana bill could not be taken up for discussion. Chief Minister Kiran Kumar Reddy made a U-turn on the bill, and this is a cause of worry for the TRS as the bill could be delayed further. The Andhra Pradesh Assembly again witnessed uproar over the Telangana bill when YSR Congress refused to discuss and demanded a resolution on the bill. Chhattisgarh Chief Minister Raman Singh expanded his Council of Ministers on Wednesday. State Governor Shekhar Dutt administered the oath of office and secrecy to nine ministers at Raj Bhavan in Raipur. In the first phase of cabinet expansion, Chief Minister Raman Singh included nine ministers in his cabinet, which will have a strength of 13 members. Maharashtra Governor K. Sankar Narayanan has refused sanction to CBI to prosecute former Chief Minister Ashok Chavan in the Adarsh housing scam, leaving the agency with no choice but to close the case against him. Chavan, who had to resign from the post of the Chief Minister of Maharashtra after the scam surfaced, was among the 12 who were charge-sheeted by the agency in connection with the case. Madras High Court dismissed bail petitions of 35 crew members of a US ship who were arrested on charges of illegally carrying weapons on board the vessel and straying into Indian waters. The crew members of the ship MV Seaman Ohio were arrested on October 18th by Tamil Nadu police after it was intercepted by the Coast Guard. They were booked under the Arms Act and Essential Commodities Act. Siddharth Vashisht, alias Manu Sharma, who is undergoing life term for killing model Jessica Lal in 1999, was granted 9 days parole by the Delhi High Court to appear in postgraduate exams. Justice Hima Kohli granted parole to Sharma from December 28 till January 5th next year after the police filed a status report informing about his examination in post-graduation in human rights, which will commence from December 30th. Dense fog once again hit the operations at the IGI airport in Delhi on Wednesday, delaying the schedule of over 40 domestic and international flights. The fog even disrupted train movement in North India for the third consecutive day, with around 50 Delhi-bound trains, including Rajdhanis, running behind schedule.